my dear students, today we discuss a very important term that is called fatigue stress concentration factor. Fatigue stress concentration factor, or the notation is given by KF. So before going to fatigue stress concentration factor, we should know, already we have discussed stress concentration factor and effect of stress concentration factor, how to reduce stress concentration factor. So again we have to repeat some important points. Stress concentration factor Kt. Kt is equal to F max divided by F zero. Okay. So F max zero, that is maximum stress at the discontinuity, and F zero is the, that is called nominal stress, or the that stress that we can find out by Fundamentals equation. Okay. Now, that is also called form stress factor. That is, theoretical stress concentration factor, also called form stress concentration factor. Now what it is called form stress concentration factor, you know that the stress concentration factor, that Kt, it depends on the type of notch and shape or size of notch, type and size of the notch. Okay, it depends on type of the notch and size of the notch. Or in other terms, we can say that depends on size, depend on geometrical form of notch or hole, geometrical form of notch or hole. That's why it is called form stress concentration factor. Now this theoretical stress concentration factor, or this form stress concentration factor, that is very much that is different from the actual stress concentration factor. The form stress concentration factor, or the theoretical stress concentration factor, is different from the actual stress concentration factor, because actual stress concentration factor depends if you consider it is capital K, that actual stress concentration factor depends on the material and the type of loading. So you can see theoretical stress concentration or form stress concentration factor is depend on the type and shape or the geometrical form of the notch or the discontinuity. But actual stress concentration factor, that depends on the materials and the type of loading. That's why this actual stress concentration factor, that is less than the theoretical stress concentration factor. Now question, why this actual stress concentration factor is less than the theoretical stress concentration factor? Because you know that if you consider a hole and if you apply load, where maximum stress is developed there? Maximum stress is developed here, where discontinuity is there. Okay. sigma 0, sigma max or f0, f max. F0, f max. So why are discontinuity is coming, stress concentration is coming at the discontinuities. So at the discontinuity is coming, maximum stress is developed there. So what will happen? That stress, in actual case, that stress, you know, the every each of maximum cases, the material are elastic or you can say plastic. So while at the discontinuity, while load is applied, what will happen? Gradually yielding will occur. So that yielding will occur in the due to that localized stress. Okay, due to that localized stress, yielding will occur, and that localized stress will be distributed or redistributed around the section. Okay, that's why your stress concentration is reduced. So actual case, your stress concentration is reduced. So there is a relation between stress concentration, actual stress concentration K, and theoretical stress concentration Q, KT, that is 1 plus Q into KT minus 1. There is the relation between this actual stress concentration factor with form stress concentration factor or theoretical concentration factor. Now that Q is notch, that is called notch sensitivity, notch sensitivity index. We'll discuss later. Now notch sensitivity also depends on, notch sensitivity also depends on the materials and type of loading. And notch sensitivity, whatever we have discussed, that is for ductile material, because plastic and elastic, plastic stress is there, elastic stress is there. So in case of ductile material, when we apply static load, we are also discussing with static load. When static load is applied, that actual stress concentration factor is reduced. Why? That localized stress will be distributed, redistributed or rearranged throughout the section. That's why your this stress will reduce. Okay, that stress will reduce. So actual stress concentration factor also reduces in case of static loading. Okay, so and in case of ductile material, so in case of ductile material, your notch, the value of Q is also zero. Zero means no sensitive, that means no sensitivity. Okay, due to the stress concentration. And also you know that, you should know that for ductile material, that's why stress concentration KT is not used. That is for use for ductile brittle material. Okay, so in case of brittle material and ductile material, stress concentration is not used, because you see your Q becomes zero. So zero means your K becomes 1, actual stress concentration factor becomes 1. Okay, so I have discussed why stress concentration factor KT is not used for ductile material in case of static loading. Okay, now go to the main term, that is fatigue stress concentration factor. Fatigue stress concentration factor, a component where the component is under fatigue loading. When the component is under fatigue loading, that fatigue stress concentration factor, that will come there. Because fatigue stress material will fail due to the fatigue. Okay, ductile material or any other material, if the component is under subjected to variable load or the dynamic load, the component is subjected to fatigue. So the fatigue resistance of the materials will reduce in that case. So one term, that is fatigue stress concentration factor, is used in place of theoretical stress concentration factor. Okay, so there is a relation between theoretical stress concentration factor with fatigue stress concentration factor. That is, before going to fatigue stress concentration factor, KF, fatigue stress concentration factor is the ratio of, that is the ratio of tensile strength of So, fatigue stress concentration factor is defined by endurance strength of notch fixed specimen to the endurance strength of notch specimen. Okay, so there is a relation between fatigue stress concentration factor and your theoretical stress concentration factor KT. Okay, so in the static load or the in the static load we have used K is equal to 1 plus Q into KT minus 1. So that K is here in fatigue stress concentration factor, that K is replaced by KF. Okay, so that is for fatigue load or dynamic load, and that is for static load. Okay, now notch sensitivity Q. What is notch sensitivity? Notch sensitivity is the sensitivity of a notch, sensitivity of a notch or hole. Okay, that means discontinuities, if there is any discontinuities there, that is the measure of sensitivity of the discontinuities. That means notches or holes due to fatigue loading. Okay, that is called notch sensitivity index Q. That notch sensitivity index Q, how to find out notch sensitivity of the Q is find out by actual stress over nominal stress, then the actual stress over nominal stress where during fatigue, and the theoretical stress over nominal stress, that is theoretical stress, that means your KT will be there, so that will be KF. So actual stress, your actual stress during fatigue, that will be KF into sigma 0 minus sigma 0. So sigma 0, that is sigma 0 is the nominal stress. So that is actual stress over nominal stress, and theoretical stress over nominal stress, that will be KT into sigma 0 minus sigma 0. Okay, so theoretical stress over nominal stress. So you can put KF sigma 0 minus sigma 0, KT sigma 0 minus sigma 0. So ultimately sigma 0, if you consider sigma 0 common both side, so KF minus 1 and sigma 0 KT minus 1. So it becomes kf minus 1 kt minus 1. Okay. So ultimately q is equal to q into kt minus 1 is equal to kf minus 1. So we have to find out kf. So kf is equal to 1 plus q into kt minus 1. So that is the fatigue stress concentration factor, relation between fatigue stress concentration factor with theoretical stress concentration factor and notch sensitivity. Okay. So now you can see that there are two conditions. If q is equal to 0, if you put q is equal to 0, what will happen? Q is equal to 0, that means your kf is equal to 1. Okay, fatigue stress concentration factor becomes 1. That means q is equal to 0, that means no sensitivity. No sensitivity. Okay. Now if you put that value of q ranges 0 to 1. Value of q is, that range of q is 0 to 1. Okay. Now you put 0. Now if you put q is equal to 1. If you put q is equal to 1, in that case, kf is equal to kt. Okay. Now, if any given material, if any materials you have given and no values of q is given, no sensitivity, nothing is given in exam or any other, the value of q was not given, in that case you have to consider q is equal to 1. Okay. Now, how to find out the value of q? How to find out the value of q? Value of q can be found out by two charts, one for reverse bending and for axial loading, notch sensitivity chart. Notch sensitivity chart. So that is nose radius, it will, nose radius will increase, and here it is q. So it varies from 0, 0.1, 0.2. So ultimately it will be 1. Okay, and that will be nose radius 0.1. 2, 3, up to 4. Okay. Now, if you consider a so notch sensitivity depth chart is for reverse bending and axial loading. Okay. So if you plot a graph for aluminum alloys, okay, that is for aluminum alloys. Then steel of 400 newton per mu square, that is ultimate strength, FUT, ultimate strength. Then steel of 700 newton per mu square, that is 1000 newton per mu square, then your 400 newton, 1400 newton per m square. So this type of chart will be there. From that chart, you can find out. If you find out, if you know the nose radius, its corresponding value of q you can find out. But remember that value of q will be ranging below between 0 to 1. Okay. Now that is for reverse bending and axial loading. For torsional load, that is again very 0 to 1, 0 to 1, and that is nose radius again 0 to 4. Okay, that is for nose sensitivity chart, and that is nose radius, nose sensitivity chart for torsional load. So that is for aluminum alloy. So another two graph will be there. That is for quenched. That is quenched and vinyl hardness BH and greater than 200, VHN less than 200, that's quenched bronze steel, that is quenched steel, and rather that is your alloy steel. Okay, so you can find out the loss sensitivity index for torsional load. Okay, so another chart will be there, through which you can find out the loss sensitivity index. This chart will be given in your each and every books. You can see the books of Bhandari, you can have this chart. So nose sensitivity index q, again it can be find out by one formula, that is 1 by 1 plus a by r. One formula is there, so you can find out the nose sensitivity index. So that a is, there is material property that depends on the material and the type of loading, and r is the nose radius, and A is your A is material constant. So that material constant A will be given, and nose radius you can find out from the given sample. So that from that equation you can find out the value of Q, and so once you find out the value of Q, so you can find out Kf is equal to 1 plus q into kt minus 1. So kt, how it can be find out? Kt can be find out from the chart that I have given for different geometrical shapes. Okay, for simple reverse bending load, reverse axial load, of plate, or stepped bar with fillet radius. So that value you can find out again from the chart. Okay. So once you find out the value of Q, KT, and you can find out the value of Q from there, then you can find out the value of KF. Now, that is the fatigue stress concentration factor. So you can see that fatigue limit Fe is equal to Fe dash into K size factor, surface factor, temperature factor, reliability factor, then load factor. So efficacy, case size factor, surface factor, that is temperature factor, reliability factor, that is load factors. Then one is fatigue stress concentration factor, KF. Now you can see that KF should be less than 1 or less than 1. Otherwise, what will happen? If you multiply, your KF should be less. Because why this KF should be less? KF should be less by introducing KD, or that KD is equal to 1 by KF. That is called modified fatigue stress concentration factor. KD is equal to 1 by KF, because your value of KF should be less than 1. Why? Because due to the stress concentration factor, your endurance limit or fatigue limit should be reduced. So how to reduce? If you take KD is equal to 1 by KF, so that your fatigue limit will reduce. That will be 1 by KE or 1 by KD. Okay. That is called modified fatigue stress concentration factor. Because why modified fatigue stress concentration factor is used? Because due to fatigue loading, your stress concentration will be reduced. So stress concentration will be reduced if you consider modified fatigue stress concentration factor. Okay. So ultimately you can see that fatigue limit is depend on FE dash already I have discussed. FE dash is the standard sample. So FE dash is equal to 0.5 into FU. Then size factor depends on the size, suppose 7.5 diameter. Surface factor, you can consider polished material 1. Temperature factor, if it is 300 degree, so you can consider 1. Reliability factor, if you consider 50% reliability, you can consider for 50% reliability, that is 1. Load factor, if it is for reverse bending or reverse bending load, then we can consider 0.85 or 0.8, then 1 by KD. So 1 by KD will be it will be 0.67 or 0.8 something. 0.7. So that is ultimately if your endurance strength or fatigue strength of your given sample. Okay, so that is the value. FE is known, so you can find out ultimately the FE. Okay, so you can see that fatigue limit or endurance limit is depend on different factors. In exam, if nothing is given, so you can consider all. One, okay, all the terms you can consider one. So I think today's lecture you have understood, and if you have any query, please do not hesitate to ask me any question. Okay, thank you.